The majority of the chemical reactions and biological processes that take place within the human body are governed by a class of biomolecules known as enzymes. Now, virtually all enzymes are proteins. Some enzymes are, in fact, RNA molecules, and we'll discuss those separately. Now, enzymes are these protein molecules that assist the chemical reactions that take place within the human body. So, before we discuss the major chemical processes that take place within the human body, such as glycolysis, fermentation, or cell respiration, let's discuss and define what the role of the enzyme is within the human body. So enzymes are biological molecules, are proteins that increase the rate of the reaction. They increase the speed of that reaction by decreasing the activation energy of that reaction. Now, recall that the activation energy is basically the amount of energy that must be inputted into our reaction to overcome that energy barrier, to basically reach that transition state and transform the reactants to the product. So to see what we mean, let's take a look at the following diagram. So the y-axis is the energy, the x-axis is the reaction progress, it's the time. So we have the reactants, and this is the energy of the reactants. We have the products, this is the energy of the products. Now, for the forward reaction going this way, we see that the reactants are at a higher energy level than the products, and that means this is an exothermic reaction. So going this way, in the forward direction, we have an exothermic reaction, and energy is released into the surroundings. Now, for the reactants to actually transform into the products, we have to input enough energy. Specifically, we have to input this amount of energy, which is our activation energy. It's the activation barrier. So basically, if we input this amount of energy, the reactants can basically reach the transition state and then convert to the products. And what protein enzymes do, what enzymes do, is they basically bind to the reactants in some form or way, and they actually lower the activation energy by basically providing a completely different reaction pathway. So the rate of chemical reactions depends on its activation energy, and enzymes increase the rates of reactions by decreasing the activation energy. The activation energy is the amount of energy that must be added to our system, to our reaction, to transform the reactants to the transition state and then to our products. So basically, this is the first important point that we must know about enzymes. So enzymes increase the rate of the full reaction, but they also increase the rate of the reverse reaction. So this is a very important point that most people sometimes miss. So if we look at the following diagram, we have the full reaction going this way, and we also have the reverse reaction going this way. Now, for the forward reaction, this is the activation energy. For the reverse reaction, this is our activation energy. It's the energy difference between the transition state and the energy of the product. So we have an exothermic reaction going this way and an endothermic reaction going in reverse. And we see that when the enzyme actually lowers the activation energy, so this is our uncatalyzed reaction that does not involve the enzyme, and this is the graph for the catalyzed reaction that does involve that enzyme. Remember, enzymes are basically catalysts. So we see that when we lower the activation energy, we not only lower the activation energy for the forward reaction going this way, we also decrease the activation energy for the reverse reaction. So that is a very important point to remember about how the catalysts, our enzymes, basically lower the activation energy. Now let's move on to the second important point that we must always remember about enzymes, biological catalysts that basically speed up reactions that take place within our bodies. So although enzymes increase the rate of the reaction, although they do in fact affect the kinetics of the reaction, they do not affect the thermodynamics of that reaction. And what that means is the concentration of the products that are produced at the end of the catalyzed reaction is exactly the same as the concentration of products that are produced for the uncatalyzed reaction. So at equilibrium for the catalyzed version, we still have the same exact concentrations of reactants and products that are left over and formed. So although enzymes increase the rate of reaction, they do not increase or decrease how much product is actually formed. That means that for catalyzed reactions, the same concentration of products is reached at equilibrium as for the uncatalyzed reaction. So that means what our enzyme actually does is it increases the rate of the reaction. It basically decreases the time at which we reach equilibrium, but the concentration of reactants and products is exactly the same. It's unchanged at equilibrium. So equilibrium is reached faster, but the actual concentrations of the reactants and products at equilibrium does not change. Now, let's move on to the third important fact about enzymes. So biological enzymes, biological catalysts, do not change the energy of the products, nor do they actually change the energy of our reactants. And that means the change in enthalpy or the change in Gibbs free energy of the overall reaction does not exactly change. So to see what we mean, let's take a look at the following two graphs, which are basically these graphs here. So notice that we have the reactants and the products. So this line is the energy for the reactants. This line is the energy for our products. And this is our uncatalyzed reaction. So we do not have the enzyme here. This graph, however, represents the same reactants and the same products, but now we have that enzyme. So basically we lower the activation energy, but notice that the energy of the reactants and products does not change. So when we calculate the change in Gibbs free energy of this reaction or our change in enthalpy between the products and our reactants, we see that it's exactly the same as for the uncatalyzed and the catalyzed case. So we see that enzymes do not actually affect the energy of the products, nor do they affect the energy of the reactants. And finally, the final important point to remember about enzymes is that enzymes are not actually used up. They are not actually consumed in any reaction. And if the enzyme is altered in some way, and usually they are regenerated. The final enzyme is exactly the same as the initial enzyme that basically went into that reaction. So enzymes themselves are not actually consumed during reactions, although they might alter in some way. For example, when the reactant binds to the active side of our enzyme, it might change its shape ever so slightly, but at the end of the reaction, our enzyme is always regenerated in the same form as it basically went into our reaction. So this is a very important property of enzymes, because that means a very small quantity of enzymes can be used to basically speed up many reactions at the same exact time. We do not have to actually use up our enzyme and create new enzymes, because one enzyme can basically react with many different reactants. So that is expressed in the following expression. So let's suppose we have reactants A and B. We place our enzyme. That enzyme basically takes A and B and reacts them. It decreases the activation energy to form product C and D, but the actual enzyme at the end of the on the product side is exactly the same as the enzyme on the reactant side. They are not actually used up or destroyed in any way or form. So these are the four important points that you must must always remember about the role of enzymes in the human body. So enzymes affect kinetics. They do not affect thermodynamics. That means they only increase the speed or the rate of the reaction by decreasing the activation energy. They do not affect the energy values of the products or the reactants, and they do not affect the concentration of the products and reactants that exist at equilibrium. They do not affect equilibrium. They simply increase the time. They basically decrease the time at which equilibrium is achieved. Equilibrium is achieved faster with enzymes, but the concentrations are exactly the same as before without the enzyme. And the final thing we have to know is enzymes themselves aren't used up, they are not consumed, they are not destroyed. They might be changed ever so slightly, but at the end, that same enzyme is regenerated. And that means that the enzyme can be used over and over again to basically assist with that same type of reaction. Now, in the next lecture, we're going to discuss two important models that are used to describe how enzymes actually interact with our reactants, also known as the substrate.